input and output characteristics of BJT in CS CE configuration. So BJT means bipolar junction transistor, that is the current flow is due to both minority as well as majority charge carriers. So the terminals of BJT are base, collector, emitter. Here the arrow mark in the emitter indicates the current flow direction. So here I am using the NPN transistor. So the current is flowing from base to emitter. If you use PNP transistor, the current is flowing from emitter to base. That is the arrow mark is inverse arrow mark. So let us do the experiment. So here you have to do input and output characteristics. So in order to do the input characteristics, you have to maintain the output voltage constant. So first I am connecting this transistor in CE configuration, that is emitter is grounded and base is emitter is grounded, or emitter is common to both base as well as collector. So here input side is base, output side is collector, emitter is common to both input as well as the output. So in order to measure the input current, I am using one ammeter. In order to measure the voltage between the base and emitter, I am using one voltmeter. This voltmeter measures the VBE and this ammeter measures the IB. So in order to limit the current through the circuit, I am using one resistor which is having the value of 10k. This is the RPS. In order to energize the circuit, we need to apply some voltage. That voltage is given by the RPS. So here RPS is the variable voltage, that's why I am using arrow mark. So RPS, this resistor is used for limiting the current. Ammeter measures the input current and voltmeter measures the voltage between the base and emitter. Input current is IB for CE configuration, VBE is the input voltage for CE configuration. Similarly, the output side also I am using some RPS in order to supply the voltage, 1k resistor to limit the current, and this measures the output current. Here my output current is IC in CE configuration. This voltmeter measures the voltage drop between collector and emitter, that is VCE. So we have to perform input and output characteristics of the CE configuration. So in order to do the input characteristics, we have to maintain the output voltage constant. Input characteristics are nothing but the curve between voltage versus current, that is VBE versus IB. So in order to do the VBE versus IB, you have to maintain VCE at constant. Similarly, in order to do the output characteristics, so output characteristics are nothing but VCE versus IC. So you have to draw the curve between VCE versus IC. So in order to draw this curve, you have to maintain your input current constant. Now first we will do the connections. So this is BC547 transistor. This is the semicircle shape. So my first one is emitter, base, collector. Emitter, base, collector. So I need to connect emitter to the ground, because here it is common emitter configuration. So this one is emitter. So I am connecting the emitter to the ground. So let us now we will start the connections. So input side I am having the 10k resistor. So this is the 10k resistor, brown, black, black, red. So here I am connecting the 10k resistor. So for 10k resistor, RPS positive, channel 1. I am using the two channels of RPS. So this is the channel 1, this is channel 2. So both are used for the voltage only. So channel 1 positive is connected to the 10k resistor first, and negative is connected to the ground. So after that I am having ammeter. So input side I am arranging one ammeter, micro amperes ammeter and voltmeter. Output side also I am taking voltmeter, ammeter. This ammeter, output side ammeter represents the IC, output side voltmeter represents the VCE. Input side ammeter represents the IB and input side voltmeter represents the VBE. So I am connecting ammeter positive to the 10 kilo ohm resistor second end. So this is the input side ammeter. So I am connecting ammeter positive to the 10 kilo ohm resistor first end, and I am connecting ammeter negative to the base of the transistor. So here this is the base of the transistor. I am connecting this one to the base, and I am having voltmeter. Voltmeter positive is connected to the base and negative is connected to the ground. So this is voltmeter. I am connecting positive to the base, and I am connecting negative to the ground. So these are all in same horizontal line, and same these are all in same vertical line. So next, output connections. Here I am having one voltmeter. So positive is connected to collector, negative is connected to the ground. So output side voltmeter, positive is connected to the third terminal collector and negative is connected to the ground. Next I am having ammeter. Negative is connected to the voltmeter, positive that is nothing but collector only. So negative is connected to the collector only. Collector only. So next here I am having one 1K resistor. So this is the 1K resistor. Brown, black, black, brown. So I am taking 1K resistor. So 1K resistor, one end is connected with the ammeter, positive. Ammeter positive. So 1K resistor, one end is connected to the ammeter, positive. And 1K resistor second end is connected to the RPS, positive. Second channel RPS positive. So second channel RPS positive. Here second channel RPS negative is connected to the ground. So this is all about the circuit. Next, in order to do the input characteristics, what we want to do? So in order to do the input characteristics, you have to maintain output voltage constant. This ammeter represents output current. This voltmeter represents output voltage, input current. So I have to maintain output voltage constant. So in order to maintain the output voltage constant, I need to change the channel to knobs. So I am changing the channel to knobs. So I am maintaining my output voltage at some constant level. So if you push this knob to this set, this indicates channel 2 voltage, channel 1 voltage. So I am changing the channel 2 voltage. So I am maintaining my channel 2 voltage, voltmeter reading it, some 1 volt. Then don't touch these knobs. Just simply vary the channel 1 value. Vary the channel 1 value. According to that, note on the channel 1 voltage as well as current. So that one indicates the input characteristics of the CE configuration. So in order to do the output characteristics, you have to maintain input current constant. So once you observe, so initially I am maintaining VCE at 1 volt. So I am changing the channel 1 voltage and note downing the channel 1 voltage, and correspondingly I am note downing the voltmeter reading as well as ammeter reading. So VCE at 1 volt and VBE is initially 0, IB is 0. So if I am changing these RPS values, accordingly the VBE value as well as IB value changes. So do the same procedure by maintaining VCE at some 3 volts. So this is all about input characteristics.